Welcome to my class on subarachnoid system. I am going to tell you in detail about the cisterns. Okay, first come to what are the cisterns? What is the meaning of this term cisterns? So cisterns are nothing. They are actually dilated the subarachnoid space or spaces around the brain. They are anatomical spaces. So certain situation or certain location in brain region, this two meningeal layer, that is arachnoid matter and diameter, in between there is a subarachnoid space. So usually the subarachnoid space is uniform in most of the places. In certain location they are anatomically dilated. So this dilated subarachnoid space is known as cisterns. So cisterns, they are subarachnoid space, they're nothing but subarachnoid space in between arachnoid and diameter. Now again, look at the subarachnoid space. As you know, the subarachnoid space contains CSF, that is cerebrospinal fluid, some of the large blood vessels. So blood vessels include arteries and veins. Some larger veins, they are located in between this subarachnoid space, and some of the roots of the and or the parts of the cranial nerve is seen in between the subarachnoid spaces. So the subarachnoid space or subarachnoid cistern is of great clinical significance due to presence of the cerebral arteries, veins, and some of the cranial nerves. And sometimes there occur a damage to this vascular structure, or mainly this arteries, which can cause bleeding, which can lead to the condition known as subarachnoid hemorrhages. Either it can be due to certain trauma or head injury, or either due to some pathological condition. Now come to structure of the cistern, how this cisterns they form actually. As you know, this pia mater, they are closely adherent to the this contours of the cerebrum as well as cerebellum, and actually they follow each gyri and sulci, that is this elevation and depressions, while this arachnoid mater only cover its superficial surface and it is bridging across the gyri. So this elevation, these are the gyri, and this depression, they are sulci. So arachnoid mater is not following each depression, that is sulci, and due to this, this leaves wider spaces between pia mater and arachnoid mater, and this spaces or cavity are known as this subarachnoid cisterns. Now look at this image. Here this blue color line is subarachnoid space, and this red line, it is closely adherent to the brain tissue. These are the pia mater. So here there is a space in some situation which is wider as compared to the normal subarachnoid space. So these are the cisterns. Now although these cisterns, they are described as a separate spaces, but they are actually not separate. They are continuous, but they are only separated by this trabeculated porous wall with various size of opening. So look at this subarachnoid space, this is a spider web like space. So through this porous opening, the CSF is flowing. Now again, look at this image. These are major four cisterns. Apart from this, there are some minor or smaller cisterns. What are the major cisterns? Posteriorly, two large cisterns. One is look at number one, that is cisterna magna or cerebellomedullary cistern. It is located just below or under surface of cerebellum and on the dorsal surface of medulla. So as its name itself describes, the cerebellomedullary cistern. Next is look at this interpeduncular cistern number 2. It is present in front of midbrain, this cerebral peduncles or crust cerebri. So it is related in the region of interpeduncular fossa. Next is this prepontine. So on the ventral surface of pons, this prepontine cistern is located. Now dorsally, look at this number 4, this quadrigeminal cistern or cisterna ambiens is located, and it is just posterior to the midbrain, where you will find this colliculus. It is two superior colliculus and two inferior colliculus. Together they are known as corpora quadrigemina, so that's why its name is quadrigeminal cistern. and it is also known as superior system. And in this system, it is closely related to the pineal gland, so it is also known as pineal system or peripineal system. Now I am going to tell you about the details about each system and some of the other smaller systems apart from this four major system. First come to the cerebellomedullary system or cisterna magna. So it is one of the largest subarachnoid system, and I have already told about location. It is located below the under surface of the cerebellum and on the dorsal surface of medulla. Now it receives CSF from fourth ventricle via a median opening or aperture, that is foramen magendie. Now come to its communication. Above, it is in communication with the superior system, and below it is continuous with the subarachnoid space around the spinal cord. And laterally and anteriorly, it is in continuation with the prepontine system. Now come to the contents. The contents are some of the important arteries and cranial nerves, their roots and rootlets. So one of the major content is this vertebral artery, and the origin of pica, that is posterior inferior cerebellar artery. Now this 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th cranial nerve, as you know, their origin from the in this region of the brain stem. So they are related to this large cisterna magna. Now look at the location of this vertebral artery. Right here, it is located in cisterna magna, and these are the cranial nerve rootlets originating from the this medulla of the region of brain stem. Now clinically, the cerebellomedullary system is important because sometimes this cisternal puncture is done in this region to aspirate CSF for diagnostic as well as therapeutic purpose. Now come to this interpeduncular system. Its situation or location is right in front of midbrain, that is in front of two cerebral peduncle. Now this interpeduncular system, it is continuous below with this pontine or prepontine system, and above or superiorly it is continuous with the chiasmatic system, that is right above the cella tarsica. So this chiasmatic system is in relation with the optic chiasma, so right above the cella tarsica. So anteriorly, this interpeduncular system is continuous with the chiasmatic system. Now look at the contents of this interpeduncular system. The major content is this part of circle of Willis. The circle of Willis, how this circle is formed, there will be separate class. But this branches of circle of Willis is also a part of this interpeduncular system. Now another content is this basal vein. So therefore, a formation of basal vein in this region. And this third cranial nerve, as you have seen, this third cranial nerve originates from this region of medial surface of cerebral peduncle. So this third cranial nerve is also a content of this interpeduncular system. Now in this image, look at the location of the circle of Willis. So here this circular arterial arcade is circle of Willis. It is located in the region of interpeduncular fossa. But one important thing to observe here is only this posterior portion of circle of Willis is actually located in region of interpeduncular fossa. The anterior half and their branches, they are located in the region of chiasmatic system. I will not go into the detail of each and every branches and this formation of circle of Willis. Look at some of the important branch. Look at this anterior cerebral artery, that is the anterior continuation of this internal carotid artery. And look at this posterior cerebral artery, which is actually the continuation of this actually the branch of this vascular artery. And this medial cerebral artery, it is again one of the branch from the this internal carotid artery. So this different branches you will find in some of these systems, which I will tell you in further slides. Next, come to the prepontine system. As its name suggests, it is related with the pons. So it surrounds the ventral aspect of the pons, and it receives CSF via this lateral opening of the fourth ventricle, that is foramen of Lasca. Now, what are the contents of prepontine system? The contents are this major artery, that is basilar artery, and anterior inferior cerebellar artery, and the origin of superior cerebellar artery. Apart from this artery, the sixth cranial nerve is, as you know, the origin of sixth cranial nerve, it is seen in the region of this prepontine system. Look at this basilar artery running in the basilar groove. So it is one of the content of this particular system, that is prepontine system. Now come to this quadrigeminal cistern or cisterna ambiens or superior cistern. It is located dorsal to the midbrain, below the splenium of the corpus callosum. Here it is corpus callosum, and this posterior round portion of the corpus callosum is splenium, and above the cerebellum. So this is the location of quadrigeminal cistern. Now, as I have already told you, now this cisterna ambiens, actually it is lateral to this midbrain, and the cisterna ambiens, it is actually a communicating cistern in between this interpeduncular cistern and superior cistern, that is quadrigeminal cistern. So cisterna ambiens, it is located lateral to the midbrain. Now this two cistern, they are divided into two part by this tentorium cerebelli into supratentorial and infratentorial compartment. Now come to the contents of quadrigeminal cistern. The major content is this great cerebral vein. So sometimes this cistern is also known as cistern of the great cerebral vein. Now the content of the supratentorial portion and infratentorial portion is different. In the region of supratentorial portion, this basal vein of Rosenthal is located, and this posterior cerebral artery. Now on the infratentorial portion, the superior cerebellar artery is located, and this important cranial nerve, that is fourth cranial nerve. So as you know, this fourth cranial nerve, it emerges from the dorsal aspect of the midbrain, then it winds around laterally and appears in the ventral aspect of the midbrain. So this fourth cranial nerve is one of the important component in this region, that is quadrigeminal cistern and cisterna ambiens. In this image, look at this basal vein, and it joins to form this great cerebral vein, and ultimately this great cerebral vein is draining into the straight sinus located in between this occipital lobe and this upper surface of the cerebellum. Now look at the region right above this pituitary gland. This is the cella tarsica. So here one cistern is located, that is known as supracellar or chiasmatic cistern. So actually it is related to the optic chiasma. Again, it is divided into pre-chiasmatic and post-chiasmatic based on the region located in front and on the back of optic chiasma. The content of this region is anterior cerebral artery. Now this chiasmatic cistern is continuous with the another important cistern located in front of this cavity of third ventricle, that is cistern of lamina terminalis. So I think you have seen these boundaries of third ventricle. Anteriorly there is one thin lamina, it is lamina terminalis extending from this optic chiasma to the anterior commissure. So in front of this lamina terminalis there is a cistern of lamina terminalis. The contents of this cistern is anterior cerebral artery and anterior communicating artery. And some of the branches of this anterior cerebral artery, like habenular artery, and some other arteries like hypothalamic artery and origin of frontoorbital arteries. So these are the structures or artery present or located in the region of cistern of lamina terminalis. Now another cistern is this insular or sylvian cistern. It is located in the region of the sylvian fissure. Look at this region in between this blue color frontal lobe and this green area, that is temporal lobe. There is one sulcus, that is lateral sulcus or sylvian sulcus. And important contents of this region is medial cerebral artery and medial cerebral vein. One more important cistern that is related to the spinal cord, it is lumbar cistern. It is located just distal to the this distal end of the spinal cord. So distal to the conus medullaris, which is located at the level of this L1 and L2 vertebra. And the cistern is in between this L1 and L2 to the second sacral vertebra. It contains this phylum terminal and nerve rootlets of this chorda equina. Now, it is from the cistern that CSF is withdrawn during lumbar puncture. Now come to the subarachnoid hemorrhage, clinically important condition, which is nothing the bleeding into the subarachnoid space, either due to direct trauma or head injury or due to some pathological condition. Like in hypertensive, there occur abnormal dilatation of the blood vessels, which can lead to a condition known as aneurysm, and due to rupture of this aneurysm, there occur a bleeding. Now patient present with this type of symptom like severe headache of rapid onset, vomiting and decreased level of consciousness or loss of consciousness, fever, sometime present with seizures. Now after going through this topic, to sum up, you must remember what are the different cisterns located around the brain and brainstem, their location and their contents are important clinically. Okay, this is all about cistern. Thank you.